Outback Jack here. It's raining outside, so I couldn't go outside today. But I went outside and I get a big pile of dirt and I put it on my plate. And look what I found. What is this? Oh my goodness. What is that? It is a worm. You're right. These are worms. Look, I have two worms on my plate here today. Worms are kind of cool. They help everything grow outside. And they keep the plants growing, and they take, when they eat, they take little bites of dirt and they spit it back out. But it keeps the soil and the dirt moving around to keep it good for us to grow good crops in. If we didn't have any worms, we wouldn't be able to grow a lot of things. Worms, kind of funny, sometimes their tail looks just like their head. So if we were looking at these worms, we wouldn't know which is the head and tail. But look right here. See how that's discolored? See, it's like a little pink. Like this is a little brown, and this is a little brown, and then in here it's pink. This is the head of the worm. So wherever this is, that's where you know the head is. So his head is over here. So hi, little buddy. How are you? This worm over here, this looks like the tail here. Tail sometimes is flatter. I don't know if we can see it on this one. And worms cannot bite you. So as you can see, I'm touching the worm and moving it around. Actually, yes, right here is the discoloration. So this would be its head. That would be its tail. They have little tiny segments. I don't know if you can see if it'll focus. Yeah, see those little tiny segments? It looks almost like rings. Those are the little segments of a worm. And that's how they move their body because they don't have arms or legs. They don't have teeth. They have no teeth that helps them. See, you can see that part really good there now. Okay, no teeth, so they can't hurt you. The only thing is they do carry a lot of bacteria and things on their body, so I suggest if you ever find a worm outside, ask mom and dad, say, hey, can I pick up the worm before you touch it? Because then after you touch it, see how my hands are all brown and dirty? I want to go wash my hands off good, because sometimes worms carry eggs. And if we touch those eggs, they might have babies. You might wake up and find eggs on your table. So you don't want to do that, okay? Worms are kind of cool because guess what? Do you think they're boys and girls? Guess what? They're a boy and a girl. So kind of cool that they can do that. They are a boy and a girl. How many hearts do we have inside of us? We have one. That's right. We have one heart. Worms have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I was just Googling something the other day and I found out they were saying worms can have up to 10 hearts. So, wow, that's kind of cool knowing that worms can have 10 hearts. They don't have any eyes, so they can't hear, but they sense light because they breathe through their skin. So right now these worms are really moving because they want to get away. They're like, hey, there's light. I'm drying up. I need to find darkness where it's warm. Now in here, there's some worms in the dirt. They're not moving because they're fine. They're like, hey, I don't feel any light. I'm covered up. I'm nice and cold. There's one moving in there. You can see him moving a little bit, but these guys are like, hey, put us back. We're drying out. And sometimes worms come out after a rainstorm because worms breathe through their skin. Oh, so look at them. So they breathe through their skin. So if they get too much water in them, just like in a pool, when we go underground in a pool, we'll say like, we can't breathe. Well, that's how a worm is. He's under the ground and that water comes in. He's like, oh, I gotta get out, I gotta get out. Then when the sun comes out, he's like, no, we need to get back in the ground again. Okay, because they don't wanna dry up, but if the ground's too wet, they can't be in the ground. So that's why a lot of times you see worms coming out after a rainstorm. But they're kind of cool. They don't hurt anything. And like I said, they're really good for our flowers and our plants. They help them grow. So if you see worms in your garden, keep them there. That's a good thing. You want worms in your garden. And believe it or not, worms have little tiny hair. We cannot see their hair, but if you looked with a really close microscope, you'd be able to see that they have hair on them. See, like we can't see. And right there, you can see that band. You can really see it on this one, that band here, which is its head. Let's see if I'll let me turn him over or she. Yeah, see how it's really discolored there? That's his head. This is his tail. So when I send you the book today, Diary of a Worm, you'll hear the sister says, yeah, or the boy laughs at the girl and says, your head looks just like your tail. And the mom doesn't find that very funny. So, okay, well, enjoy these worms. If you find worms outside, again, ask mom and dad before you pick them up. But worms are very cool. We don't want to eat these worms. You can eat gummy worms, but these are actually real worms today. All right, well, I'm going to put them back, and actually, I'm going to release them outside because these were actually, I cheated. I bought these in a store. They're 12 Canadian crawlers, or otherwise known as night crawlers, so they're really big. The worms you find outside are more like earthworms, but there's all different types of worms. There's mealworms, earthworms, redworms, all different kinds, but I got these ones today because they're fun to play with, but then I'll put them outside in my garden, and they'll help things go, and who knows, maybe the birds will pick it up, because sometimes birds like to eat them too, but at least they won't be used for fishing. Okay, so Outback Jack. Hope you learned a lot about worms today and have a great day. Bye.